you doing this? Why you doing this? No disrespect, but I want sex and can I screw your lips? Oh, too disrespectful for y'all. Well, you got my jawbreaker trying to break up your jaw.
I'm gonna claim my name.
Straight up good game.
Chainsaw game.
Like a rhino.
Running through the forest pack.
Figure I'm trigger happy niggas so you step back.
Breathe. The microphone is.
Who lasts the longest?
Who's the strongest?
And games playing to see.
You listen to the sounds of Breed.
And the DMC, it'll be a job.
Hey, man.
Yeah.
We want to welcome y'all, man, to the first episode of Respectfully Disrespectful.
Respectfully Disrespectful. We just made that up today.
What does respectfully disrespectful mean?
That mean like you disrespectful, me I'm respectful.
That's crazy. You just throw me under the bus?
Nah, I mean, not like literally. You know, you're a nice guy.
I mean, because they don't understand that you aren't a nice guy. You make it seem like you are.
Yeah, that's respectfully disrespectful.
So why is that? Why do you run with that whole little...
All right, so this how it started, right? Unc probably could contest this. So when you a youngster and you wear glasses, they just throw you in the nerd category. They just automatically, boom.
Right.
So since you can't see... They equate that to you being a sucker.
Right.
So I'm like, oh, I'm just going to run with this. This is what y'all, oh, cool. Okay. Yeah, for sure. I got you. You know what I'm saying? You wear yours on your sleeve where it's like, oh, Stan, he don't give a fuck. But me, feel me, I can get away with more shit because they don't expect it.
That is true because you get a lot of the conscious sisters that be like, oh, I love Kevin. Like, I go to your shows, you get a lot of the conscious sisters. They really be on you. How you feel about that?
I mean, I am conscious. You know what I'm saying?
I mean, I'm conscious too, but they don't be on me like that.
I mean, because you don't act like that's what you about, even though it is what you about. You see what I'm saying?
All right. So, have you ever got ran?
No.
What? Listen, this is a long-going subject with me and Kev. You see, we're adulting here. This is Stanley and Kevin. This is our show. This is Stanley and Kevin, Respectfully Disrespectful. And the concept of this is... I want him to admit this. Now, to the fellas out there, I want to ask y'all this. Have you ever got ran?
No.
What I mean by that is, has a woman ever called you after decent hours and hit you with the, what you doing? And your response is, I'm just chilling. What's up? And she says, I'm about to come through. You're like, all right. She comes through. She has sex with you. Then she says, I holler at you. That's never happened to you.
What I'm saying is, when you already make a plan, that's the plan. She's not getting over on anything.
I'm not saying she's getting over.
That sounds like hitting a lick, like somebody hit a lick and you didn't know. Or nah, like if she says, this is what I want to do, and you like, and you okay to it, you're like, yeah, okay, I agree. Yeah, come through.
You okay to get ran.
It's not a run if you're okay with it, though, to me. If you're okay with it, it's a mutual agreement between two willing participants. That's what I'm saying.
Would you let R. Kelly babysit your daughter?
What?
I'm just asking a question. That's respectfully disrespectful.
We both got daughters.
Right.
So... My answer is no. But why would you ask that after the run question? Let's get into it.
I don't know. It just was on my mind. And females be getting ran. Like, he caught his run.
Nah, that's not a run. He Emmitt Smith, if that's a run.
I'm not laughing at... I'm not laughing with him. I'm laughing at him.
You laughed.
Can I ask you a question?
I don't know.
Did Michael Jackson sleep with them little boys?
I wouldn't dare, but I'm probably going to say he probably shouldn't have been in the bed with no little boys to make that even a question. If you don't want to get in trouble, don't put no little boys in the bed with you.
They asked me earlier, if you had a son, would you let Mike sleep in the bed with him? Your son get in the bed with Mike? I'm going to get in the bed with Uncle Mike.
But you wouldn't let R. Kelly babysit your daughter?
Because I don't feel like Michael Jackson did nothing to them little boys. I felt like he was a kid, and it was like them was his friends. In his mind, he was still a kid, and he was just having a sleepover.
But if R. Kelly in his mind thought he was 14.
No, but it wasn't in his mind. It was in his body. He could hear him calling him. He was a predator.
He can't read.
I just feel like Mike ain't do nothing to them kids. I feel like Mike was just like, hold on, man. It's nothing wrong. I mean, the nigga bed was big as the store. So it's like, you could sleep in the bed with Mike and not even play footsies.
Nah.
All right.
Nah. The more kids in your bed, the creepier. You just adding more kids, bruh? Nah. And I fuck with Mike, bruh. I fuck with Michael Jackson, bruh. Just don't add hella people to the situation. You're adding more fuel to the fire. That's, you know what I mean? It's like, come on, bruh. You can't.
Was Kobe wrong for trying to take the booty?
For sure was. For sure was.
What was wronger? Him trying to take... Wronger. Yes. Nigga laughing. Him trying to take the booty or him telling on the people he told on, saying, oh, they did it too?
Snitching. What you do in your behind closed door, that's on you. If you like butt, that's on you. Do that behind. Don't start trying to drag everybody else down with you because you like the butt. I just feel like there's too many regular vaginas out there willingly for you to take somebody's butt. Like, my guy, what are we doing here?
I'm not going to like you. What if he said I like you and I want you?
That's still, though.
And I want you.
That's still too much, bro.
I like you and I want you. He's a booty warrior.
How you let that backfire? If you weren't trying to get her pregnant or whatever your excuse was, and that's what you chose to do, you could have just got some head, cuz. You could have just kept it 100 and got some head, and you didn't have to put it in her butt, bro.
Speaking of butt, did you see Madonna butt job?
Nah. What's that about?
You didn't see Madonna butt job?
Nah.
Oh, you got to look it up. We need to... Can you look up Madonna and pull up Madonna's butt job
on the... Google search Madonna's butt.
Put her butt job up on the projector. We trying to act like we got hella shit.
McDonald's butt.
We got trying to act like we got hella people up right here working and shit. Yeah, yeah. Can you pull it up on the projector?
Yeah, pull
it up. I need to see. It ain't a motherfucker back there.
I got my phone out. Madonna. How you spell Madonna?
M-A-D-O-N-N-A.
Is it two A's or two N's?
Two N's.
Madonna's new butt.
Yeah, her butt. She out of pocket, cuz.
Madonna's new.
She out of back pocket.
Madonna's new body.
You got to see it. Let's see it. Let's see your thoughts.
This is ridiculous.
Let's see.
Stupid, bro.
Share.
She look crazy.
Please share.
She look crazy.
Oh, wait.
This nigga, oh, wait.
Oh, wait.
You running on Madonna, bro?
Would I hit Madonna?
Yeah.
Hell yeah.
Never.
Nigga, you wouldn't fuck Madonna?
No. No.
You don't like white women? No, I'm not fucking this. This looks like Kurt Cobain.
Nah. She is Kurt Cobain.
Nah, Madonna arms don't look like that,
Madonna,
do they?
Madonna was an adult, nigga, when I was born.
What that mean?
That means I'm not fucking nobody's grandmother, bro.
You wouldn't fuck a gilf?
No.
So you honestly mean to tell me you wouldn't...
Bro, I'm looking at her. I'm looking at her.
Grab my phone, cuz.
No. No, I'm not. No. No.
You're not having sex with Madonna just for the energy?
No.
That's crazy.
Not at... Hey.
Top five list. Who you... Top... No. All right. Well, give me top five you would hit celebrities.
If I wasn't happily married.
Oh, true. I forgot. True.
It wouldn't be Madonna. This shit gross. I'm trying to find one where I could be like, oh, I'll see how. Nah, I ain't.
My nigga, it's Madonna. You don't fuck her for how she look, cuz. That's.
How do you fuck if you don't like the way the person looks?
Cause that's Lady Eloise. Lady Eloise, she owns a company. Lady Eloise.
Still, bro. I'm a sensitive guy, bro. If the smell don't, if it ain't right, if the bitch arms is hella saggy,
I'm fucking Madonna. I don't care what you
can't do it, bro. I can't do it. If her hands too wrinkly,
is you fucking Robin Givens?
Robin, oh, OG Robin Givens?
Yeah.
Her hands look wrinkled?
Nigga, they the same age.
Is her hands wrinkled?
Black don't crack. I don't know.
Is her hands wrinkled?
I don't know.
Robin, Whoopi.
Whoopi Goldberg.
No. Not Whoopi.
Ooh, I ain't gonna be able to do it.
I'm not touching Whoopi. Let me tell you, it's getting hot in here.
That's auntie.
See? That's all I'm saying. No auntie vibe. Sorry, aunties out there. Some of y'all look cool.
Vivica?
Angela Bassett's the only OG I'd be like, all right.
Jada Pickett?
She got auntie. She got cool auntie vibe. She got cool. These women you name.
That's auntie Sugar. I'm diving in that.
Oh, my God.
I love Will. That's my brody. I love Will Smith. But, nigga, if I had Jada? Nigga, I'm doing it for Pac. Nigga, you tripping.
Oh, my God. So, do you think Will Smith got Pac knocked down?
Whoa, that's how you getting that Will?
No, I'm asking you.
No, not at all.
So, you think it's just coincidence that they used to whatever the fuck be friends, and then Will Smith, boom, came in the pit, and then all of a sudden Pac dead, and then nobody don't know shit.
Whoa, is this the theory that we?
I'm just asking.
I don't feel like Will Smith had anything to do with Tupac getting killed.
Oh, okay. I was just asking.
Okay.
All right. Whatever.
Would you raw Angela Yee?
Who?
From the Breakfast Club.
No.
Would you hit?
I don't know.
So who your top five that would you hit?
Just my wife, but I'm married, but you can't.
Okay, outside of your wife, let's say before your wife, before, after your wife, whatever, however, just a top five, hypothetically speaking, not saying that you fantasize about these women or anything, who would you hit? And would you raw?
I'm not raw Angela Lee. Remember Webby was like, Charla McGay. I'm not. Angela Lee, but she not. These women that you naming ain't sexy to me. Bro.
Well, who is sexy to you?
It would be like Malia. She is
the stripper?
Yeah, she a stripper. I'm not wrong, but she know how to, she
might as well raw.
To me, might as well raw.
Strippers be clean, cuz.
Okay. You go.
Uh-huh. Malia, okay. I'm not gonna lie.
How about that?
All right, I go on.
The boys. Oh, that's the ambulance.
All right, Malia. Who else?
Christina Milian.
For sure. Raw.
Lauren London.
For sure.
Who else is famous? I don't know, nigga.
Any porn stars?
I don't know no porn star by name except OG Cherokee and
You don't know no porn stars by name.
Except OG Cherokee and motherfucking
niggas be out here lying, cuz. So now you haven't memorized these porn stars' names. Like you don't know Alicia Tyler or Taylor, or you don't know Simone Taylor, you don't know Cherokee, you don't know.
You do a lot of porn.
Nigga, every morning.
Every morning?
You married, so you don't gotta get that off.
That's what I'm saying.
So when you married, do you get it off in the morning still? Do you have to like.
Nah, you gotta have conversations and shit. Hey, how's your day gonna be?
So being married, you don't masturbate anymore? Like, is marriage the end of masturbation?
Damn near. You gotta be on some pure. Like, you gotta be a MacGyver if you're trying to, like, you just kids in the house, this motherfucker, like, just, you gotta be a
no goddamn homo, but when is the last time you've masturbated?
No homo. This your man right here?
Asking a question.
This your man?
I just want to know, because I've been contemplating marriage, and I just thought, if I gotta stop masturbating because I get married, I don't want to get married.
This your man? So you're not gonna marry the woman of your dreams if you can't jerk off?
The woman of my dreams already married.
Oh, so that brings me to, wait, we get back to what you're talking about. I'm not answering your jack-off question, first of all.
Okay.
But that brings me to another point. So do you think the woman of your dreams, since she's already married, do you feel like you always going to be a female second option? Like the nigga she really want is somewhere else and she just picked you just because? Or do you really feel like you that nigga for the girl?
Nigga, I'm a bitch dream, nigga. Never been a sex option, nigga.
Foolish boy.
Foolish little boy.
Foolish boy.
I'm a bitch dream.
You definitely gonna be the second option. It's always another nigga.
Huh?
It's always another nigga she wish she would've got.
Just so like, who your wife wish she would've got?
I don't know that nigga.
Y'all ain't had this conversation?
No.
You've never had the conversation like, baby, if you never married me, who you would've been fucking
with? It's probably somebody you didn't work out with.
That you know?
I don't know none of these niggas, but yeah, probably.
You think she'll still let her ex raw? Would you still raw your ex?
Never. Right. I'm a nigga that moves the fuck on.
You hey. Never go back?
Nah, can't.
I don't break up.
You don't break up.
Like, we together forever. You fuck with me.
How?
Because we forever together. I'm like that. Like, I'm like, nigga, that's my bitch.
So like how R. Kelly was saying, like.
No, nothing like me is like R. Kelly-ish.
Okay.
Nothing at all.
I'm not saying that you R. Kelly.
I just feel like we go together. Like,
don't look at nobody when they come in the studio.
Yeah, I be tripping like that sometimes.
Oh, see? Like,
I just, but it be, it's a mind thing. It's like, you know.
That's what he was saying in the documentary.
Yeah, but my bitches is legal.
Oh, okay.
Gotcha. My women, you feel, we don't keep disrespectful, you feel me? No disrespect.
I'm respectful.
No, you're fake disrespectful. Like because you is ratchet just like me, but you don't want to say it like that. Like, what is it? You politically ratchet.
Yeah, I'm politically ratchet.
That's crazy.
You know what I'm saying?
That's crazy.
I mean, I don't know.
So, you watch college basketball?
A little bit. Not recently. Since Duke been doing anything and all that shit.
Are you familiar with the Duke, the young dude, Zion from Duke?
Yeah.
Do you feel like he's going to go first pick, number one?
I think it's enough hype to make him go, yeah.
How do you think he'll adjust in the NBA?
I think when they get some weight on him and fuck get some experience, yeah, I think any nigga can go. I mean, Curry wasn't shit. Let them tell it. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, okay. I'm finna say, you just going to disrespect Curry like that?
I'm just saying.
Like, are you a Warriors fan?
Yeah, for sure. Since a little nigga.
Who?
I mean, who, what?
What little nigga? Muggsy Bowles?
No, since I was a child.
Oh, I thought you said since the little nigga. I don't know. I didn't know if he was a Lakers fan or not.
Nah.
No?
I never fucked with Lakers. Like, Magic Johnson was cool with shit, but I never really. That wasn't my thing. It was like Warriors or whatever team Michael Jordan was playing for, which would be the Bulls. And that was it. What about you?
Would you fuck Cookie?
Who was that? His wife?
Yeah.
Nah, she probably got it. She ain't got the bag. He got the bag.
They both got the bag.
I mean, but he got the bag. Right?
His son wear a bag.
A Louis bag?
That nigga bag hella big. He like,
yeah, he got
big.
The bag. His son got the bag.
He like carrying the
His son
speaker.
Got the Fendi bag, yeah.
He got bag. Every bag. Every bag Kardashian got.
For sure, he got it. That's a big, tall, sweet dude, bro.
Is Kanye crazy?
For sure.
A good crazy or a bad crazy?
Depends on who's looking. I think he's a bad crazy because he's hurting himself.
You fuck with Ye?
I'm not throwing his music away like Kelly shit.
You threw R. Kelly all his music away?
I just haven't listened to it before all of the shit came out. Like after TP2.com, I didn't listen to Step in the Name of Love. I didn't play none of that
you
shit.
You never anyway. Stepped in the Name of Love?
Nah, never. That's just not my swag. That was like 45 and up swag.
Step in the Name of Love go crazy, nigga. You up here lying now. You trying to defend this shit too serious. I ain't gonna lie. I fucked a bitch the other night to Step in the Name of Love.
This your man? Is this your man? Okay. Me personally?
Did you just
TP2 slapped all the way
hella
to
hard.
The bottom.
Half on the back.
That's my favorite R. Kelly.
But you'll never listen to it ever again.
I can't even say I won't ever, but I just haven't ever went back.
Okay.
I don't got none of my playlists. It just wasn't something I went back and was like, ooh, I got to hear that, whatever the fuck, you know what I mean?
So, with Ye, what do you feel like?
I feel like his shit will come on. It might be something he produced for Keisha Cole or something, or it might be a old song off of Twisted Fantasy or just something that I like, okay, this shit slap. Like, Kanye was in his, I don't just disregard him because he's crazy like that. And I kind of like, I went to a couple shows and shit where the show in San Jose where he kind of like spazzed out, I was at that show.
Who is at that show too?
And I was like, no, I understand what he's saying. They only took little certain parts of what he said, trying to make him seem more crazy than what he was. And I was like, oh, that's kind of fucked up. I see how the media like twisting nigga words up.
Greatest rapper ever?
Lyrically or business-wise? Because I'm going to say Hov.
Business-wise, Jay-Z.
Yeah.
Lyrically who?
Pen-wise, probably Eminem.
Pen?
Pen-wise. Probably M. I never
P-N,
seen
M. Yeah.
I never seen a nigga put too many words together like, bruh. Like, he fucking around.
But I just don't think nobody could fuck with Hov, like, all the way around. Like, if we had to do it all the way around, I think I would go with Hov.
Yeah, well-rounded MC, businessman, entrepreneur, metaphor, all that shit. It's going to be Hov. It's going to be Hov, hands down.
Biggie or Pac?
Biggie.
You got Pac fucked up, nigga.
No, I don't.
Fuck wrong with you, cuz.
It was too much Hennessy. It was too much of that for me after a while.
This nigga up here, cuz. Are you serious? Biggie over Pac?
You talking about rapping, right? You're not talking about influence, or you're not talking about...
I'm just talking about, nigga, if you on a deserted island and they say, nigga, this you got to listen to this for the rest of your life, Biggie or Pac's catalog, who you
listen
to? Okay,
that's not the question you asked.
Nah, Biggie or Pac?
Pac got way more music than
okay,
Biggie.
Okay, well, one album.
Me Against the World. It's gonna be Life After Death if it's one album.
Life After Death is better than Me Against the World?
No. But if we pick in one album, that's the album I like.
So Biggie over Pac.
Yeah. Life After Death got more slaps on it, to me, than Pac's double album.
Is Wayne in the conversation for best rapper of all time?
Most songs of all time. One of the dopest rappers of all time. But he started catting off after a while. He put out too much music that was like, all right, just let somebody else rap real quick, bud. You doing...
Does Rick Ross pick the best beats?
Yeah.
Do you fuck with Ross?
Yeah.
I really fuck with Ross. Ross is really dope to me.
So was Ross a police for real? or CO? Was he a CO? Was that a real picture? Was that him? This is your friend. You know, you fuck with Ross, right?
I've never been in jail, and I've never seen him in a CO outfit.
Like, does a tree fall in the woods and make a sound?
Sound is measured by sound, so someone has to be there to measure it.
Who was in jail when he was a CO? Do you know those people?
Maybe the real Noriega.
Okay. Okay. He owe him 100 favors?
No, I don't know why he would owe him 100 favors.
I don't know either.
I don't know.
I don't know. What? I feel like on some rap shit. Yeah, Ross one of them niggas.
I think Ross is that guy. I fuck with Ross. So you fuck with Nipsey or Meek?
If I gotta pick them two?
Yeah.
Nipsey.
I fuck with Nipsey. I like Meek though. Meek new album's hella dope.
Yeah, Meek hard. But if I gotta pick, it's gonna be Nip.
I love Nip. I love everything Nip do, man. I love what he represents. I love how he keep it sick for the coast, you feel me?
Yeah.
He does his thing. What's the fastest you've ever rawed something?
The fat what? Is this your man? This your man right here?
You ever rawed on the first night?
I ever rawed something.
Have you ever rawed on the first night?
Yeah, my wife, bro. When we started kicking, I was like, damn, girl, I'm about to.
Oh, that's crazy.
I'm about to raw you and marry you.
First night?
Yeah, first night. It was in there. No, it wasn't the first night, but.
Have you ever got burned?
Burned? What does that mean?
An STD?
No.
Never?
Burned? No, never got burned.
Craps?
What?
I had crabs before.
Craps? You mean like?
Crabs. I had crabs before.
Oh, yeah. No, I never had that before.
I got crabs.
That's crazy.
I'm being honest. This is.
Oh, you've had. Oh, I'm sorry.
Yeah, I've had crabs before.
Sorry, no offense.
Bitch gave me crabs when I was young.
That was scandalous.
Super.
Was it actual like little like?
Yeah, you could see them.
You could see them?
Like, listen, they start pet, like, they planted seeds, then they hatch.
Oh, they too bad at you.
Like, listen, bro. God. And I was like, oh my God.
Oh.
And I seen a little, like, the egg, like, they was like, and I'm, like, I, like, kind of, like, popped it, like, the little egg, little white, and I'm like, mama. I was like, mama, what's this? She was like, nigga, a bitch done gave you crabs. Nigga, go and get some Lindale lotion. It was something, some lion dye, Lindale, some shit. And I had to shave off one side of my pubic hairs, right? I was a young nigga. I'm about 16, 17. I'd shave off one hair, put the lotion on there. They went to that side, and I shaved them off. That shit was vicious. Young nigga, man.
They was doing?
They was just
having a gangster party?
Gangster party on the nigga pubic hairs. A pure gangster party in the nigga pubic hairs, man. That shit was vicious, man.
Oh, shit.
I seen a bitch not too long ago, too, and I was like, she was like, hi, fam.
Dirty bitch.
Like, no, bitch. Don't high-five me, bitch. Bitch, you gave me crabs when I was young. She was like, no, I did. You got me fucked up. No, bitch, you got me fucked up.
You seen that shit on Instagram? And niggas like, bitch, I fucked another bitch. I gave it to you, bitch. My bad. Hello?
Bitch, whooped me when I was young, man.
Yeah, that's scandalous, bro. No, I haven't participated in the crab movement.
None of that?
Nah.
Okay.
That's crazy.
Okay. All right.
I mean, you know, sorry I couldn't join you on that mission.
It's all good. We're not going to always agree on everything.
Nah, it's cool.
2019 goals. Some of your goals for 2019.
The transitions are hilarious to me, by the way.
It's like, randomly disrespect. It's respectfully disrespectful.
My goals for 2019. Really just to keep on the same path I was on, bro. Just a bunch of reading, a bunch of knowledge, a bunch of like work, being in the lab, fucking with you in the lab, fucking my nigga Frank, fucking with a lot of people just working, making music.
Frank who?
AKA Frank.
I like Frank. Frank is dope.
Yeah, he dope. It's my little brother. Shout out to Frank. Who else am I working with? Myself, you know what I'm saying? Getting back on the production side, doing a lot of live shows. Just, you know what I mean?
By the way, I love your live show. It's amazing.
No, I appreciate you.
Your live show is pretty.
You,
it actually brought me to tears. I watched the first night when we watched the Kevin Allen Project, and I was watching it, and you was performing at the Uptown, and I was like, it brought me to tears because just watching the shit, the song, I think it's Often. Is that it? No, it's not called Often. It's about basically when you were talking about your mom, like you just wish she would tell you that she loves you more often.
Yeah,
what's the name
of
that song? You don't know the name of your own song?
No, I don't really care.
Niggas be Charlesing,
cuz. Why you think anything I say is Charles?
My nigga, you don't know the name of your own song, and I just explained to what the song was. It's called Love Me. You don't love me often. Love Me Often. What's called? Oh, you a fake ass nigga talking about you don't know the name of your own song. Thanks for everything. Thanks for everything.
He used to do me out. It was called Often.
Yeah, I thought it was something like, nigga, you just, you wanted it.
It's called Thanks for Everything.
So how did that make you feel? Like your mom didn't love you?
I mean, she did. That's not what the song's about, though.
I just said, I had a kind of feeling going up.
This nigga's so sick.
I just wanted to know, mom.
This your man right there.
I just wanted to know if she loves you or not.
Nah,
like,
I mean,
because I felt kind of bad, really, like, damn, she didn't fuck with you.
If you really listen to this song, it was just saying, thank you for even all the lessons you taught, because I still learned
right
through all the shit. So if you really, like, get into, like, growth and, like, self-help type shit, you right understand that, oh, everybody got issues. So to put it on my mom, like, she wasn't perfect,
right,
that's scandalous to me. Like, who the fuck am I to judge her when I don't even know what she been through?
That's right.
You know what I'm saying? So let me give her some just dudes instead of, like, having a chip on my shoulder. Let me just talk about it and say, like, nah, this kind of what we been through. You know what I mean?
So you still fuck with moms?
Yeah, for sure. Like, for sure.
Can I ask you a question?
Yeah.
It's disrespectful. We get one disrespectful question.
One?
Like, kind of. More than one, but...
All right, go ahead.
All right, so I was doing a survey...
okay.
About 6 months ago, right? And I was just asking a few niggas.
Uh-huh.
And I told a nigga, if it came down to it, would you fuck your mom for $1 billion?
A what?
$1 billion.
I'm going to take my headphones off. It's hard to hear you.
I don't want any problems, Kev. I just only asking a question. I asked my nigga, I said, cuz, would you fuck your mom for $1 billion? And the nigga said, would I fuck her? Not only would I fuck her, I fuck her good. For $1 billion, I swear to God, the nigga told me that he would stroke slow with moms for $1 billion.
Is any of them niggas in here today?
No, not here right now.
Any,
I swear,
niggas, I said,
my nigga in Denver, I'm not lying. I'm not going to put his name on the podcast like that.
Yeah, out of state.
But he a Denver nigga. It was me and Nooch. Nooch will contest this, that this was true story. I
call
said, my
Nooch
nigga.
We need a guest caller
I
right
said,
now.
My
call
nigga,
somebody, call
would
Nooch.
You fuck your mama for $1 billion? He say, would I fuck her? Not only would I fuck her, nigga, I fuck her good.
Get Nooch on the phone. We need to patch Nooch.
Please give me my phone, cuz.
Hold on, do I got
Nooch? I have to call Nooch for this Billy. Hold on, bro.
Hold on, bro.
But hold on, bud. I swear to God, this is a true story, bud.
How do you spell Nucci?
Watch this, bud.
Is it two O's or a U?
Hold on, bud. Watch this, bud. Y'all niggas think it's a game.
Oh, so my answer is no, bro. Like, no.
Okay.
It's getting crazy.
I'm just asking. I mean, my mom dead right now. And
if she was alive... For $1 billion.
I would have to talk to her.
See, you look like your mama. This isn't even true. No, nigga. No. No.
Hey. I don't think I could do it. Cuz, listen. So, do you remember when I can't say his name because I'm recording live, so I don't want to say his name. But do you remember when I asked the nigga, would you fuck your mama for $1 billion?
Yeah.
What did he say?
Give me the check, cuz.
That nigga said, give me the check, cuz. Not only would I fuck her, that nigga said, I'll fuck her good, cuz.
Hey, I'm done. Niggas is sick.
Cuz, am I lying, cuz? Niggas was stuck thinking I was lying, cuz.
Hey, he's sick on
me. You would fuck her for the Billy. Cuz, I'm going to call you right back after I get off this show.
Nah, bro. Sick on me.
Cuz, I swear to God, the nigga said he would fuck mom for a Billy. Hey, so listen, man. Respectfully disrespectful, man. And the whole purpose of this show, man, is we just ask each other random shit about current topics. And it's random shit, man. And it happens like that, man. So
wait, I didn't ask you nothing.
Okay, well, I'm waiting.
I didn't ask you nothing. So I was at another podcast a couple months ago, and it was some legendary rappers in the building. You know what I mean, from the town. I'll leave them nameless as well because I don't want to eat feel me. They was talking about they be getting their ass ate. Is that something that you're into? Is this new? Is this what the kids are doing these days?
I got my ass ate before.
Okay.
I got my ass ate before.
Next topic.
I'm not gonna lie. You never got your ass ate?
No, sir.
You've never let a bitch eat your ass?
No, sir.
At all.
No, sir.
Kiss it, lick the balls, none of the
balls ain't the ass. Wait, what?
Under the balls, they go under the balls and...
Put some taint where it ain't. We can put some taint where it ain't, but we ain't licking my asshole.
You never got your ass licked?
No, can't do it.
Got your toes up?
kissed, not sucked.
Any desires to get him sucked?
Nah, I mean, I'm some old school, young, disrespectful shit. Suck my toes, bitch.
Not in your current situation.
Nah, that's ridiculous.
Have you ever ate ass?
No, I'm not an ass eater. I don't even have an ass eater face, is what I've been told. Like, nah, you good. You don't have an ass eater face.
So you haven't put your tongue nowhere all over your wife?
Not in her ass. We ain't doing that. No sorry about it.
So if your wife came to you and said, babe, I just want to expand our sexual relationship a little bit. I want you to eat my ass.
She wouldn't ask me like that because you know I'm a real nigga. But if she wanted to, I'd have to like think about it, talk about it. Okay, well, you know, maybe we can experiment in the future. You know what I'm saying? I'm not going to ever tell her no because my philosophy is if I tell her no, it's another nigga that's going for sure. Eat her ass. So I got to see if there's something I'm willing to do.
You ain't never been eating a pussy. And like I said, with all due respect to your wife, I love your wife.
Because you're like,
yeah. I love your family. Y'all, we family. We all family.
You feel me? And I hope. Fuck your mom.
You know what I'm saying? Our kids, we're family. Okay. Our kids play together and all kind of stuff. And I hope they never hear this podcast.
You should have thought about that before.
Shit happens. You brought it up. You've never been eating her puss and just felt like, let me lick the ass.
No. Okay. Let me lick that. But first of all, this is a question about you getting your ass ate.
And I said, yeah, I got my ass ate before.
Why?
Bitch was nasty. I just wanted to see the bitch if she was gonna do
so
it.
So did you put your legs up?
Yep, I did. Oh, I'm not gonna lie. I was laying back on my back.
You went out.
Now let me tell you. Let me be real. This one keeping it real. Cut. I'm laying on my back. No, dude, we're gonna run this shit.
You let me run.
I'm on my back. Uh-huh. And she's like start going on the balls and she go low and I'm like, oh bitch, you nasty. So I just kind of lift the leg up a little bit, like you, Deion Sanders, high step on the bitch. High step the leg up a little bit, and she, I'm like, oh shit, like okay, bitch,
this is crazy.
So
right?
Then I turned around on my stomach in the bitch.
Oh, ate you from the bizac?
Ate the ass, man.
Oh, you got ate from the bike,
man. If a bitch ate from the bike, man.
Come
ate
on,
the ass,
bro. You playing?
Man, that bitch ate the ass, man.
100. Then you called her again? For the rematch?
I don't know if it was a rematch. I don't know if we had a rematch.
We can't never put this podcast out.
Why?
We got to do a whole nother one.
Why?
This is the only clip they're going to listen to.
Man?
Fab got his ass ate on his stomach.
This going to world star.
Y'all didn't get y'all ass? Am I the only nigga in here that got his ass ate? Okay, thank you. I'm good.
Who said that?
My cousin. Got his ass ate. Cousin, you got your ass ate before?
On your stomach?
Man, keep it real, man. Nigga, we keeping it real.
No, I didn't.
All right.
She let me on my back.
Okay. On your back?
I turned over on my stomach, man.
Legs up or no?
I done had it like twice. She was on the
okay. You never got your ass ate? He ain't gonna never tell the truth about nothing. This baby Jerry.
Okay.
Baby right. You got another disrespectful question.
So it's just me?
Yeah, you never got your ass ate.
Oh, y'all niggas.
Would you feel comfortable telling your wife to eat your ass?
I wouldn't ask her to eat my ass.
Why don't you ask her?
I'm feeling like I'm like, wait, what world am I in? This is so everybody getting their ass ate but me.
Hey, you might have to try it. Might have to get your ass ate.
Me, okay.
I'm sad. Maybe you might have to try it, man. Now,
all right.
I ain't never got my ass played with a no faggot. Excuse me, I'm going to keep the censorship to our sponsors. I ain't never had no shit, no objects or no fingers or none of that shit. Strictly lips and tongue. Bitch didn't lick the rim shot of the nigga.
Okay, you Eric about doing it.
Give me a rim shot, hey.
Nigga. Okay. All right, 2 inches old, you know what I'm saying?
All right, shit.
Well, you want to go ahead and wrap this?
We're going to wrap this up. I didn't know if you wanted to shoot another one. I'm honest, man. If you come on this motherfucking show, you're going to have to be 100% honest. Oh, this ain't man. No bullshit. We shooting it straight. You can't get mad. You can't be offended. It is what it is. We respectfully disrespectful.
I'm not sure where the respect part is.
Because it's respect for each other. I respect you.
Oh, yeah, okay.
I respect you.
I respect you enough to be honest.
To be honest.
Okay.
Even in your disrespect.
All right. I kind of see what you're saying.
Let me ask you.
Okay.
You ever had a threesome?
Yeah.
Foursome?
No. I don't force nobody to do nothing. You know what I'm saying? I'm a real nigga.
Three bitches.
Nah, I never did. I never had three.
Okay.
That's out of control.
Just two?
Yeah, that's two.
Oh.
You?
What?
Foursome?
Yep, I woke up with three bitches before.
Woke up? Did you go to sleep with them?
Yeah, for sure.
Okay. It was cool? It was lit?
Yeah, it was beyond lit.
Stupid lit.
It was one of them nights.
That's when you got the rim shot?
Nah. I was younger then. I wasn't getting my ass ate then.
Okay.
This has come with older age.
Oh, okay. Maybe so. I'm just a late bloomer.
Yeah, you might wake up one morning and just be like, you know what, babe?
No. No. I don't think I'll ever wake up and be like, hey, I was talking to Fab last night.
Is your extreme nasty? Is you nasty? Like when you eat pussy, do you spit back in it?
No.
See, we different.
Yeah.
Do you choke and slap? They just when you
know. Oh, I thought you meant I'm not choking while I'm eating a pussy while I'm choking. Slow.
Wait, have you what? Ever just fucking choked the broad hella hard and spit in her mouth?
No, I never spit in nobody's mouth.
We different.
That's how you get her? Oh, that's that Meek Mill shit. Oh, but no, she spit in
this
his mouth.
This was before Meek. This
I you let her spit in your mouth?
Did she spit in my mouth before?
Like a loogie? Or like a gleek? Or like
not a gleek. It was a little more, not a loogie, not a gleek.
Oh, it was in
like you got to be from the era to know what a gleek is.
Old school.
Okay, so it's not a gleek. You got to be from the dope era to know what a gleek is. So it's not a gleek and it's not a loogie.
Okay.
But I didn't spit all in the bitch mouth, on her face and everything.
Oh my God, bro.
Everything. I've done it all. I've pretty much done it all.
Okay. Well,
with the woman.
I think I might just be like a regular freak, just like a regular. You know what I'm saying? I might need to like step my shit up or something.
But you married, so I don't want you to step it. I mean, but if you do step it up, I believe you'd be stepping it up with the woman for the rest of your life.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. I didn't really know niggas. Like,
you suck toes?
Before my wife, yeah. She liked it. It's cool. She in the bathtub and shit. She was sexy.
Oh, was real sexy?
Yeah, it was sexy.
Okay.
She was in Africa.
You was in Africa?
Yeah, she was crazy.
Oh, that's raw.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? Motherland.
Took it to the mother. You should have ate some ass in the motherland.
I didn't even think about that.
Respectfully disrespectful. Right. Episode one. I'm Stanley.
I'm Kevin Allen.
And until next time.
Whoa.
The disrespect continues.
Peace out.